Hello and welcome to Cooking Shooking. Today we are going to prepare mawa or khoya. Preparing this is very easy and very basic, but there are dozens and dozens of recipes prepared using this, from sweets and desserts to curries and gravies. And people also prepare mawa using milk powder, but like that, the taste and the texture is a little bit different. We have a festive season around the year in India and people sell adulterated sweets in the market. So what's better than preparing sweets at home? Eating fresh is always the best, and we'll have some sweets in the upcoming days from rasmalai, gulab jamun, peras, pantuas and more. So let's start preparing our khoya or mawa. We require fresh full cream milk for preparing our mawa or khoya. So let's start preparing this. Here I have a kadhai in which I'm going to add the milk. I'm using 500 milliliters of milk, and I am using fresh full cream milk, and it will give best result. So our procedure for preparing our mawa is only stirring the milk occasionally to prevent any burns. So we just have to stir this milk until this all milk gets like a paste and comes all together and leave the sides, and at that stage we are going to remove this from the heat. Another thing also happens while you stir regularly is the cream or the malai does not separate from the milk, and we get a very nice and good mawa or khoya, whatever you call. And this is pretty much very thick at the moment, and at this stage lower the flame to simmer and cook this nicely until it leaves the sides. So you can see we have got our milk very thick and very nice, and it's almost like a mawa or khoya now. And to prevent it from sticking to the sides, I'm going to just add a drop or two of ghee. This is really optional if you are using a non-stick pan, but to be on the safe side, I'm going to add just a little bit of ghee to it and mix it thoroughly and cook it for another minute in the lowest flame, and this khoya or mawa will be ready. So our mawa or khoya is ready. This is at the haryali mawa stage at the moment, which is used for our gulab jamun, pantua and more sweets. But if you want a mawa that is stiff and hard, like we get a soap like a mawa in the market, that is known as bhatti mawa, or the mawa that is settled up. If you want that mawa, you need to cook for another 5 minutes or so in the lowest flame. But I want a mawa that is very soft and nice. I need to prepare gulab jamuns with this. You can check my recipe for that. And for that, this mawa is pretty much ready. And as it cools down, this will thicken up even more, and it will be stiff. But if you think that after cooling it down it is not much stiff and this is very soft, then you can again cook it for another minute, then it will be fine. So I have just switched off the flame and I'm going to wait until it cools down. You can see our mawa or khoya we left at that stage, but it's looking perfect if you want to use it after 12 hours or so. But I want to use it within an hour or two, but that's why it's not very thick for me. You can see it's like a paste at the moment. I'm just going to cook it for another minute so that it gets nice and little bit more thick. So our mawa is ready. I just cooked it for another minute in low flame and it's perfect, soft and nice. It has left the sides, and you can see it's not like a bhatti mawa. This is haryali mawa, very soft. Perfect for preparing gulab jamun, pantua, pedas and whatever you want to prepare, even chakkis and more. So I also have the chhena besides me, and you can even check the recipe for that. So what's better than preparing our gulab jamuns with this? I'm going to prepare gulab jamuns with my chhena and mawa. So do try and let me know how it turned out to be, and make sure you use some full cream fresh cow milk. Don't use homogenized milk. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe for more of Cooking Shooking in this festive season. What's better than preparing at home? So prepare this, prepare some sweets, and let me know how it turned out to be.